You three have nominated yourselves to lead my fleet.
This added Mohan Das to Markarvas. Under offense, project.
The Republic calls me Iceheart, for I have never shown mercy.
I am Lunata. Imperial intelligence marked me their most wanted for the thousands I slew on Scylla.
Did I ask for your credentials? What do I care if you want to get yourselves shot first?
That's always been your problem, Voidy. Can I call you Voidy? You never worry about the big picture.
Are you offering to captain my fleet instead?
Who is this?
That's her. The one who got Rogan and Noctrian.
Leave. You know your orders. This is private business between a captain and me.
The Voidwolf doesn't care if you die in this attack. You want to be around for the long haul. You're better off with me.
When I came to you, they were saying no one in the galaxy could challenge your...
You three have nominated...
Did I... That's all...
Are you...
You picked the wrong side. How hard you want it to be to back out once he's dead?
Perhaps.
I'll work for whoever's left standing.
Bare your throat now, cub, or prepare to have it torn out.
Now, tough guy.
Better than you might think.
Call you Admiral now, Captain?
Who else would command such a fleet?
Shambalumi Lois, Borjo Urvas, Dor Tortakis, Bahak for Lankas, Skuriak Gunchek, Korsla Orok, Rukwa.
Your fleet is part of the Republic now.
The Voidwolf just sent us an Imperial warship escort. Shall we start by destroying it?
Captain, I've been monitoring the Voidwolf's internal communications. He's got a failsafe set to destroy the ship. Blast! That was the hangar with your shuttle. I'd start looking for the escape pods. Otherwise, you're going nose first back to Corellia.
Good you're here. We've got trouble. You remember Counselor Belos?
Captain Kantaris tells me the Republic's on their way here. You can't attack the legislature yet. The Empire's taken control of the Ion Wall, Corellia's most powerful defense system. They're planning to use it against the Republic.
What does the Ion Wall do?
It sends out an immense sonic wave that disables ships, security, heavy weaponry, nearly anything that requires power.
If this thing hits the Republic, the Empire keeps Corellia for good.
But I have the codes. Why not turn it on the legislature's defenses instead?
Won't the Empire expect a counterattack?
They've been led to believe it's an impossibility. First, you'll need to point the Ion Wall's emitters at the legislature. They've been concealed inside statues around Capitol Square. Once the emitters are realigned, the ion wall can be activated. The controls are located inside Intracorellian Intelligence.
That's the catch. Intracorellian Intelligence was one of the first places the Empire took over. It'll be crawling with Imperials.
Some Republic troops or a Corsac squad might even the odds.
You head over with more than you got and the Empire will know something's up. Nice and quiet is our best strategy.
The Imperials aren't the only danger, I'm afraid. Several members of the Dark Council arrived in Capital Square a few days ago. One of them, Darth Acheron, was dispatched to Corellian Intelligence to keep the Ion Wall safe. You'll have to get past him.
I've never heard of the Dark Council.
They govern the Empire according to the Emperor's wishes. Only the most powerful Sith in the galaxy earn a seat. I should go. There's a secure line from Intercorellian Intelligence to my office. Contact me once you've activated the Ion Wall.
The guardhouse is still linked to the legislature. We can't control their defenses, but we can tell when they go down. I'll get Corsac and the Republic into position. The minute you activate the Ion Wall, we attack.
Supreme Chancellor Suresh, Senators, the Republic's taken the legislature, and the Empire's on their last legs. It's all cleanup from here.
A message went out across Corellia, and I'm proud to relay it to you on Coruscant. We will have our victory. We had plenty of help from our allies, but one woman stood above the rest. We owe our victory to her efforts.
On behalf of the Senate, I'd like to thank you for your service to the Republic. The General tells us you were indispensable.
General Aves and Captain Kantaris gave the orders.
We haven't forgotten. They'll both be honored for their leadership.
The Senate's heard many rumors about the Imperial invasion of Corellia. Before we continue, we'd like to hear the truth.
The Empire moved in with the Corellian Council's blessing. We fought their inside knowledge all the way to Capitol Square.
The Council showed no remorse for their actions. They've been arrested and removed from office.
The Council was loyal to the Republic for years. Why would they abandon us now?
The Empire convinced them that we were weak.
The Council went with the odds. Fortunately for us, they didn't pay off.
With the Council in jail, Corellia has no local leadership. There could be riots, crime sprees, further destruction.
After all the damage the Empire's done, the Senate is hesitant to take direct control. Who should lead Corellia through their recovery?
We've got a war to fight. Corsac can handle things here.
We'll hold elections for a new council soon. Should be nice not answering to anyone for a while.
Corellia is one of our founding planets. There was no warning before they turned. How many more worlds might be on the brink? You brought Corellia back to the Republic. You have the Senate's attention. How can we prevent other worlds from joining the Empire?
Corellia's free because the people fought back. Their reward is a big pile of rubble they used to call home. Some people call that the cost of war. I call it unfair. The Republic's too focused on the big picture. Take care of the little guys first. You never know when you might need their help.
You have the Senate's promise. We'll see Corellia properly restored.
Before you go, we'd like to thank you properly. There's no medal or title that equals what you've accomplished. But this should help.
First class blood stripes, Corellia's highest honor, awarded to those who keep fighting despite the odds.
Thank you, Captain. I'd be proud to fight with Corsac again.
We'd be proud to have you, but I'm hoping our fighting days are nearly over.
You freed Corellia from the Empire and set events in motion that may end this war. You deserve more than our thanks.
Our victory today sends a message. The Republic may falter, but we will never fall. As long as we keep fighting. Senators, let your voices be heard. Stand and recognize these heroes of the Republic. You have more than justified my faith in you. Gentlemen, ladies, this is the woman I've been telling you about, who destroyed Grand Admiral Haradax Kirill and saved our shipyards. Captain, this is Senator Roan, Fleet Admiral Helic, Supreme Commander Rance. Of course, you recognize the Supreme Chancellor. They've come to thank you for turning the Voidwolf's fleet against the Empire.
You're making me feel almost respectable.
Captain, I am pleased to present you with the Senatorial Medal of Service.
That's the highest civilian award the Republic issues. You have changed the tide of this war.
It's been fun working for the Republic. Or thinking I was, and then really, you know what I mean.
Your service has been truly priceless.
You seem to have a talent for this. Would you give some thought to continuing as a privateer under my guidance?
I can't think of anything I'd rather do.
You're a rare find, Captain. I'll be in touch with the details.
It seems there are times when it's an advantage to have an operative who isn't bound by the rule of law.
I never thought I'd see you on the Jedi Order's payroll, Captain.
Does the Republic think they have bought your loyalty with stamped silver on a ribbon?
Only you could manage to turn taking over the underworld into a good citizenship award.
I'll get Port Noir back up and running, Captain. You're going to need a base of operations, and someone at the wheel you can trust. No offense, but you're better at finding credits than keeping them. Even my father needed a broker for his empire. Gives you time to do the fun part.
Create a better future together. I realize forging a true relationship takes time, and our marriage won't be consummated for some time. But I am hopeful. My proposal stands, Teresia. Will you marry me?
Say yes. Hurry before you lose your nerve. Yes, I'll marry you. We'll make it official the old-fashioned way. Have your people bring me a written contract to sign. But let's not make it easy for the king to kill us. Until the war's over, we shouldn't meet in person. Agreed?
I will continue to send you updates as I'm able. Dubrillion will be free. Farewell, my lovely wife. May the stars watch over you.
Isn't he adorable? You make an adorable couple. I hope you're not expecting a gift on this short notice. You can owe us. I should probably do something to celebrate. Want to go steal something really expensive? I've been getting reports on the war for Dubrillion. It's dragging into a stalemate. Nobody has a clear advantage yet. I want to get more involved with the war effort, but my allies tell me the best thing I can be is a symbol.
Don't listen to those people. If you want to fight for your planet, just do it.
Problem is, they're right. I'm 100 times more effective as a rallying point for people who oppose the king. The minute I open my mouth and start talking politics, I risk losing support. I can't afford that right now. Guess I'm stuck on the sidelines until it's over. At least I have company. I've been thinking about the future a lot lately, and I had a funny realization. Every scenario I see, you're in it. I've never let myself get close to anyone. Not even my friends from the old days. Count Renald may be my husband, but you're my family. Right back at you, Risha. I don't know what the future holds for us, but I promise to always be there. Not just for you, but everyone you care about. That's as mushy as I'm getting. Back to finding trouble.
Yari Rook claims to lead his own clan. He destroyed my clan with his slander and then dares to raise up his mishmash of slavers and pirates and call them Clan Rook. And no one has challenged them.
Maybe you can kill him twice.
Twice is a mercy.
This isn't even the worst of it. The man I was with when my people fell, his clan lost all honor after I left. They joined Clan Rook. My old lover dishonors the name Mandalorian. That coward dies with the rest of Rook's filth.
Once they're all dead, you'll finally be satisfied?
This has never been personal. It's about justice. Rook's clan is on Hutta, bowing and scraping for the cartel. The scum have no discipline. Destroying their camp will be easy. When I'm finished, it will be as if Clan Rook never existed. I leave for Hutta immediately.
You look, well, not exactly happy. Less angry than usual.
It's over. The filth who destroyed my clan and dishonored its name is dead.
I'm guessing the real story is a little more complicated. Wouldn't mind hearing it.
There was little to tell. It was violent and brief. Before he died, Rook confessed his crime. He destroyed my clan because the lie gained him a favorable contract with the Empire. He killed my people for profit, nothing more. The galaxy is no poorer without him.
What about the people serving Rook? Your old lover. Did all those people deserve to die?
They had no honor. The smart ones ran and survived. The foolish ones are fertilizing Hutta.
That's great, but you can only kill your enemies once. Now what? Do you have another reason to live, or should you just space yourself right now and get it over with?
I did what honor demanded without regret. I still have this ship. And you. I could not have avenged my people without the resources and opportunities you've provided. I will repay that debt, Captain. For the first time in months, I've allowed myself to think about the future. Someday this war must end. What will you do when the Sith Empire rules the galaxy? Will you transfer your loyalties to them? What if your profession is outlawed?
I'll stay in business. If the Republic can't put a slave collar on me, neither can the Empire.
How much experience do you have with the Empire's slave trade? It's highly advanced. The only constant in life is change. A warrior prepares for whatever comes. Your talent for survival is impressive, Captain. But luck has its limits. I have no clan. And the man who destroyed it is dead. Without clan or foe, I am no longer a Mandalorian. But I am still a warrior.
and great ones don't allow old age to take them. To die in battle, dragging many foes into the void,
that is a good ending. What do you think, Captain?
I was planning to live forever. It's not as flashy as your idea, but it works for me.
I should have known better than to expect a serious answer.
I'm retiring to a resort planet somewhere. You have fun with that void thing.
You'd rather collapse into sloth and weakness? Draw your final diseased breath lying in bed? That isn't living. A warrior's end requires a worthy foe.
We should keep fighting until we find ours. Tomorrow we die. Today someone else will. Ibatur Jotne Tura Shad Kiramor. I was wrong.
Context, please?
When I joined your crew, I told you I would never serve another's interests again. I could not trust anyone's purpose to suit my own.
I was wrong.
The longer I stay, the more loyalty I feel. There is nothing in my lifetime that could make me leave your side.
You know, you're the kind of gal you know when she's mad, and you know when you've made her laugh. Master Lauren was just ice. You had no idea if he even knew you were in the room.
If I could, I'd teach you what to do with that lightsaber.
Oh, Captain. If you were my master, I might have practiced. Or at least not released the Kowakian monkey lizards into your dressing room. Maybe that was a bad plan. Captain, I just want to say thank you. I could never have imagined you would put up with me for this long. When I first came on board with you, I thought it was going to be a few weeks at most before you left me on some isolated moon.
Once you're in my crew, you're family.
Aw, Captain. You'll make me cry. Seriously, though, this is my family. More than the Jedi. More than the one I was born to. I've never been able to be myself anywhere like I have with you. I'll never leave you.
Family too, Bodar.
Look, Captain, I try not to get sentimental around you, but hear me out. You're the best thing that ever happened to me. You're my family, as much or more than the one the Separatists took. As long as I live, I'll be here to serve you, and your children after if I last so long.
You want me to have your babies? We better get practicing.
That sounds like an excellent idea.